Hi, I'm Supriya Sule, a member of parliament. My constituency is Baramati, Pune district, Maharashtra, from the NCP. I thank you all for sparing your few minutes to see this video. The whole idea of this video is to remind you all that I started a private member's bill called Right to Disconnect in the previous Lok Sabha, and I've decided to revive it because I had overwhelming response from people. And people are reaching out to me and saying, what happened to right to disconnect? In a nutshell, to tell you what right to disconnect is we all have homes, we have families, we have children. And there are several days that you really feel that you've worked hard the whole week, just that need that little time, either for your kids or your parents or your spouse or your close friends, and stay away from all that technology that we are all so addicted to. And detox from that technology, detox from work, and sort of just think, sit down, introspect, and sort of get rejuvenated and do anything that makes you happy. It could be exercise, could be a walk, could read a book, could just take a walk with your kids, go to the playground with your parents, whatever makes you happy. And I think every family deserves good quality time together. I think the whole binding force of a good society, besides good food, getting a good job, the aspirational India, today has somewhere forgotten the need of good family ties, bond, and time for your family. What was family time when I grew up? The family time when I grew up was going for a walk in the garden, going to a good bookshop, and these are the kind of things we did as a family. And I really feel sometimes when I see these kids, they're all in either shopping malls or going to some fancy places to, you know, do something which is all dependent and created happiness and activity based. So I think we all need to move away from this, and you deserve a right to disconnect from all this and connect to whatever your soul, your heart, your mind connects with. Because I feel if, suppose it's a weekend and you take that Sunday off and you sort of spend it with your family or do anything that makes you happy, and your boss calls you, of course, work comes first. But if it's not critical, you have the right to tell your boss that, sir, it's a Sunday, I've committed to my child, to doing something with your child. Can I do this tomorrow? I promise you, I will deliver it way before you need it. That's your right to disconnect, which is a right that you must have. Each one of us has. That doesn't make you lazy. We still work very hard. We must work very hard in building this nation. But at the same time, your family, your close friends, and above all, you deserve this time for disconnect. So I hope that you will put up your suggestions, because this bill is not about me, it's about us. And every vertical, then you'll ask me, oh my God, but does a doctor have a right to disconnect? Does a politician have a right to disconnect? Each vertical will operate differently. So depending on what profession you are, we can find a chart and make a program which we can recommend to the government. So I urge each one of you to contribute with whatever you think is right as a professional to make us a more professional, hardworking, and people who have good family values in building our nation together. Several countries have this right to disconnect, so why not India? I think you will have worked very hard and you have earned it, and above all, you deserve it. So it's a small effort that I'm making to change people's lives for the better. So I hope you will send me your recommendations either on email or Facebook or whatever media or medium that you think is appropriate. Please do get back to me. And I thank each one of them who have always been supportive to me and encouraged me and almost pushed me in reviving this right to disconnect. Thank you so much. Let's make a difference and improve all the lives together. Thank you. I have also take this opportunity to thank orgchange.com. They supported my petition, and I'm really proud to say that 1 lakh people have signed this petition. So obviously a lot of people, and there is a demand. So let's together push this petition for the betterment of a better life, not just for us, but our future generation, our children, who we love so dearly.